皆さんこんにちは、おはようございます、こんばんは、エミです。ロサンゼルスからお届けしております。今回の風くんの US ツアー、私ロサンゼルス公演2日参加させていただきました。1日目はね、一人でお前から2番目のセンターで見せていただきまして、そして2日目はですね、娘と2人で行ってきました。もう実は2日目の私のチケットはもう最後の最後、1日前に視聴者さんからね、安く譲っていただいて行けた状態だったんですけれども、もう私がね、2日目も行きたいというのを娘知っていたので、で娘のチケットはね、あったんですけれどもね、いやー、私のチケットはママに譲るよなんて言われてて、もう私も最後の最後どうしようかなと思ったんだけどね、視聴者様の一人に、こういう若い子にこそ特に見ていただきたいですよねというコメントをいただきまして、私もハッと、それでね、そうだよねと思って、やはり娘からチケットを譲ってもらうのは違うなと思って、娘にもぜひ行っていただきたいと思ってね、そして視聴者様からもね、ぜひ初めて風くんのライブに行った娘さんの感想が聞きたいというコメントもいただきまして、インタビューをしたんですけれどもね、本当にね、行ってもらってよかったなと思いましたね。でインタビューの形式としては、私が日本語でインタビューをしまして、娘は全部日本語は理解できるのね。で答えは日本語ではなく英語でしてもらいました。英語の方がより深く彼女のね、思っていることを表現できるかなと思って、そして私が日本語訳をつけております。でやっぱりですね、私が気づかなかったこととか、そういうことも言っててね、なるほどと思うことが結構ありましたので、皆様ぜひ聞いてみてください。ではどうぞ。
自己紹介をお願いいたします。お名前をお願いいたします。
Hi, my name is Demi Manami.
はい、私の娘のまなみでございます。ということでね、今回初めてカズくんのライブに二人で行きましたのでね、その時の感想などを伺っていきたいと思います。今日はよろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
はい、まずは、どうやってカズくんのことを知ったんですか？
When I was in high school, 2021,I was on Spotify and I was just looking at the most popular Japanese pop songs and he came up, his song Tabiji was Tabiji. The first one that I saw、mm. and I loved it、mm. so and then it just went from there.
Okay. ママがこのびっくりしたのは、その車の中で Tabiji をかけてくれた時はね、あ、日本語の曲だってびっくりしただけだったんだけども、その次の朝にまなみちゃんのお部屋に入ったらね、繰り返しずーっとリピートで旅路がかかってたのね。あれはなんで？
So I had a playlist of songs that I would sleep to,、mm. and that day I just like accidentally left it on that song, but I loved it, so、
oh.
it was fine.
Oh,、yeah. okay, I see.、Yeah. So that was accident, kind of,
but、uh-huh. I still liked it.
So, oh,、yeah. I see. Okay. そして、今回ね、初めて。ライブに行ったんだけども、どうでしたか？まずは感想。
It was very good. I think he's very talented. He has great musicality. I liked how the light work was done.
Light work?
The lighting of the whole show.、
Mm.
Because since it was just him and his piano, no、mm-hmm. dancing or anything,、
mm-hmm.
The lights were basically everything that like set the scene.
Right.
So I liked how the lights coincided likewith the vibe of the music、and how it faded in with like、certain、
yeah.
times. I thought that was very impressive.、Mm-hmm. I also liked、I liked how personable he was. He was、mm. very, very friendly, silly,、
mm-hmm.
Which was nice because、mm-hmm. it kind of reminds me that he's just human that、mm-hmm. has talent,、
mm-hmm.
which I usually don't struggle to remember, but、mm-hmm.When you're watching someone on stage, it's、mm-hmm. like, oh my gosh, they're an alien.
Yeah.
But he's very
right,
real.
Right.
So yeah, he's just very talented,、
mm-hmm.
very good at the piano.、
Mm-hmm.
The piano, my jaw was on the floor、
yeah.
the entire time because it was insane. He's、
mm-hmm.
so good at the piano.、
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, he's overall very talented, but I do see that he's very、down to earth as well.
I see. So, ライブを見た前と後となんか印象変わりました？
Before the concert,、
mm-hmm.
I guess when I would hear his songs,、
mm-hmm.
I would just think they were good,、
mm-hmm.
and I liked them a、
mm-hmm.
lot,、
mm-hmm.
But being at the live show made me realize that he does like make it. Like he writes all of it. He's able to play his music. It's personal to him, which made the music a lot more. A lot more enjoyable. I saw more of the hard work that went into his music and how he's made it like so far. Like every time I see an artist performing, I go back to the beginning. Like I wonder what they were doing like when they weren't famous. Like how much work did it take them to get here? So I really liked how it was just very apparent that he worked very hard and his music shows.
Oh, so, すごい努力家だっていうのは調べたわけじゃなくて、もう聞いてるだけで、あ、すごい努力したんだなっていうのがわかるって感じ?
Yeah, like, because it's not normal to be able to play piano like that and sing at the same time.
Without look at the music too.
Yeah, and like, his songwriting like, was very, his songwriting was impressive, his musicality, his ability to just, I guess, come up with songs like that was impressive.
Like a wording or the music or?
The wording with the music. Because I feel like some people have good words, not so good music. Good music, not so good words. But he just has such a good balance of both.
So you understand everything. 全部歌詞とかも大体分かって。
Yeah, I understand it. And when the lights went off and no one could see anything, but you just hear the piano like going, and I was like, okay, like, I don't see a light. I know there's no light anywhere for him, so it was very impressive.
I see, I see. あと一番なんか好きな曲とか好きなパフォーマンスってあった?あの中で。一つじゃなくてもいいけど。
I liked, there was this one song, I forgot what it was. It might have been...
Is it Japanese song? His song?
Yes. My favorite ones are Japanese. His covers are good too, but I like how the Japanese ones are very personal to him, his talent. I think it was Kaero.
Oh, Kaero.
Kaero, his... I think there were blue and green lights.
Yes.
And then in the beginning, the lights were together.
Yeah.
And I was looking straight. I already have bad eyesight. I don't know if that's what also tied into it, but I had my glasses on. But it felt like I was looking at the screen, but I was also just like not there. Like something about the lighting made it feel like I was just floating in the air. And I know they probably did that on purpose. Like, it was probably like a lighting trick, but that with like his intro with his piano, it was a long intro.
Right.
So I really enjoyed that. And I also liked... his crowd work was good.
Crowd work?
It's like when you go like up to the crowd and you say like...
MC.
I guess. I don't know if you
He's
call
talking.
It that. Yeah, like crowd work. Like you work with the crowd.
I see, I see.
I enjoyed how he incorporated like lyrics and like beats. Like it was very much like gospel. Because I did gospel choir for a long time.
Yeah.
It was very interactive.
Right, right, right. That's true.
And... I think of Moel.
Yeah, Moel.
I thought the entire time, because when I would listen to his songs, I was just like listening. I wasn't really listening. I was just there. I thought it was like Moero, like, like fire, right? But when he was like Moel, is like, oh, I'm done with like whatever kind of like vibe. I realized that it wasn't what I was thinking, but then I liked the song even more because I understood what was going on. But I also, I like that song.
I see. Kaze-san の英語についてどう思う? 彼の英語はどう?
I understood everything. I think it's amazing because he's able to explain concepts of his song in English, which I think is very hard.
Right.
Like when you explain how music makes you feel,
right,
if you're not good at a language, there's no way you're gonna achieve that.
I know.
So the fact that he was able to communicate what his songs mean and how they're tied to like spirituality, gospel, perseverance, just everything like that, I thought it was very impressive. But overall, his English is like I don't really pay attention. I think he's just like communicating.
I see, I see. あと、風さんの人気なんだけども、なんか、みーちゃんの友達とかさ、なんか高校とか大学とかに行ってさ、どんな感じなんだろうね。風さんの人気はどう思う?アメリカでの。
I think the following is very high、
mm-hmm.
Compared to other Japanese artists.、Mm-hmm. I don't know about、mm-hmm. compared to like popular American artists,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
but I know that if they're looking for like Japanese pop, he's、mm-hmm. probably top five、mm-hmm. easily.、
Mm-hmm.
And I posted him on my Instagram、
mm-hmm.
and I had a few friends swipe up like, oh my gosh, cool.、
Oh.
So he's very,、mm-hmm. he's known.、
Mm-hmm.
His music is good and、
mm-hmm.
like there's English in it.、
Mm-hmm.
So, and the message is good. So I'm not too surprised. Yeah.、
Mm-hmm.そう、あとね、カバー曲、カリフォルニアガールズだったかな、それを歌うって言った時にみんなクスクスクスクス笑ったんだけど、あれはなんでかわかる？
I mean, it's funny because that's like, I don't know if you're gonna understand, it's like a girly pop song. Like, every young teenage girl in America knows that song. Or not even teenage, like, even if you're 10, I think you'll know that song. And it's just such a...
Is it old song?
It is an older song. I think it's Katy Perry's song. And I think she started, I think she released it in like, oh, I don't even know. It was when I was very, very young.
Oh, I see, I see.
So it's just been an ongoing, iconic California song. But it's also about like...
Kind of just sexy song?
It's kind of like, yeah, like, just like, oh my gosh, I'm a girl. Like, that kind of song. So the fact that he was singing that was, it was funny.
Oh, it was funny. Yeah. I see. It's just like a surprise. Like, oh my god, he's gonna sing that song?
Yeah. Kind of thing. And then, like, right after, he sang Teenage Dream.
Right.
Also by Katy Perry.
Oh,
Yeah. And those are two just like...iconic、young girl or young, I don't know if boys listen to it. I think they、do. Like, everyone knows the song. But since I'm a girl, I only know what girls listen to. But yeah, it's like an iconic American culture song.
I see. それを歌ったことで、なんか風さんにもっと親しみを持った人とかいると思う？なんか、あ、こんな歌も歌ってくれるんだみたいな。
Maybe. I think it just shows how he's like...kind of like unserious in a very good way, like he's not just like there to just rip out the classical and leave, like he has a personality, like, but we could also see that during like the breaks where he would talk to us, how he would like giggle in the
night.
He seems like a very cool person,
right.
He's not afraid to show variety in his personalityLike, he's very easily vulnerable、and about, like, what he likes. Like, he,、I feel like he understands music is music、and there's no gender tied to anything.、So I feel like he's also breaking, like, the stereotypes、that maybe within, like, listening to songs like that,、like, he can still be、a cool dude、that's talented、and brought in, like, jam to Teenage Dream and, like,、you know, California Girls.、So I thought that was funny.
I see.
Yeah.
そしてね、ママが驚いたのは、あの、日本では結構ね、ママみたいな年の、結構年配の人が多いんだけども、ここの現地の人、結構若い子はたくさん来てたのがね、あ、ママはびっくりしたんだけども、まーちゃんはそれはなんでだと思う？そういう Spotify とかそういうのからかな。まーちゃんはそれはびっくりはしない？
I mean, no, because I'm young.、I have no reason to be surprised,、I guess, because they're just like, I guess, my people. But I guess, yeah, Spotify, that's how I found him. And TikTok. I feel like TikTok is huge amongst like, young people. And I know a few of his songs blew up on TikTok. So,
yeah. そうだね。最後に一つ。あの、みーちゃんからママはその旅路を聞いて、そして、風さんのことね、調べ出して、そして、風さんのことを3年前から喋り出したんだけども、ママがその風さんのことをこうやってもうずっと喋ってることに対してどう思う？
I think it's very funny. I think it's great because someone with that much talent does deserve attention. But just because you're my mom, it's a little bit silly. But I'm also glad that you have found a community that is very supportive of, like, not only him, but, like, just, like, you as a person. So I think it turned out great. But in the beginning, I was like, ooh, she's a little obsessed. But
あの、これからもママ応援していくけど、あの、よろしくお願いします。
はい。
はい。じゃあ最後に、風さんに メッセージ何かお願いします。あ、そしてあのね、誕生日がね、6月14日なんだよね。それで27歳になるんだけど、もうすぐ誕生日ですというのを踏まえてメッセージお願いします。
Okay. Happy early birthday. You're very talented. I respect your work. You work very hard and it shows. You also seem like a very old soul. I'm also around your age. I'm 21, so I recognize that it's very unique to have your mindset and your process of thinking when creating your art. So a lot of respect to you. Happy early birthday. And I hope I can meet you one day.
Okay. ということで、宮地さんありがとう。ありがとう。バイバイ。はい。
ということで、いかがだったでしょうか。やっぱり私が気づかなかったなんかゴスペルみたいな感じとかね、いろんなことを言っていたし、本当に娘に言ってもらってよかったなと、娘からねチケットをね譲ってもらわなくてよかったなと思うんですけども、というのはやっぱり今回の US のねチケット高騰問題ですよね。やっぱね、私このチケットは娘、私が買ってあげたんだけども、娘自身でこのチケットを買いたかって言ったら買えてないと思うんですよ。そんな高いね値段は出せないと思うんですよね。だからね、こういう子たちが本当に一人でも多く行けるような、そんなシステムに将来なればいいなって心から思いますが、まあこのシステムはね、アメリカのシステムだからね、どうかわからないけども、とにかく私に風くんの存在を3年前に教えてくれた娘と一緒にロサンゼルス公演に行けたということは、私にとっても娘にとってもとても大きな出来事だったんじゃないかなと思います。ということで、今日も皆様にとって素敵な一日になりますように。 Have a wonderful day, everybody. エミでした。ではまた。